بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن شاء الله we'll continue with the تفسير of جزء عامة. We reached almost the end of سورة عبس وتولى, the third surah of جزء عامة. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد حتى يرضى سيدنا محمد. مدد يا أولياء الله, أعينونا بعون الله, وكونوا عونا لنا بالله, عسى نحظى بفضل الله. We reached the point, فإذا جاءت الصاقة, يوم يفر المرء من أخيه وأمه وأبيه وصاحبته وبنيه, لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغنيه, وجوه يومئذ مسفرة ضاحكة مستبشرة, ووجوه يومئذ عليها غبرة ترهقها قترة, أولئك هم الكفرة الفجرة. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ends this surah with describing that all these people who denied, belittled, fought against Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, rejected his message, that what is awaiting them, what they denied is awaiting them. فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الصَّخَّةُ, and صَخَّة is judgment day. And the description is, Holy Quran is Allah's words. So its eloquence and the metaphors it used and the analogies are beyond perfection. So what happens on judgment day when these people who denied Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is the condition of humanity on judgment day? Allah says, يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ. On that day, يعني Allah mentions, on the day when a person runs away from his brother, وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ, from his mother, from his father, وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ, his wife, his children. يعني what people hold most dear in terms of relationships will at that time mean nothing in the scope of the what humanity will be facing in terms of the great signs of Judgment Day. 1,000 years humanity will be waiting in difficult conditions to be judged. أهوال يوم القيامة, the afflictions of the day of judgment. So when faced with such horrors, the unbelievers who denied that day find themselves now living that day. And the horrors are such that even the relationships between a father and a mother, between their children, will at that time mean nothing. What does it mean when a person runs away? It means, I cannot help you, leave me alone. I'm worried about myself on that day. My full concern, my fears, my panic, is all for what will happen to me. يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ يَوْمَئِذٍ مِّنْهُمْ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِيهِ. He said everybody's condition, everybody's his concerns are enough to make him blind to everything. His fears on that day will be enough to make him blind to everything, to keep him busy. And this Sayyidina Ibn Kathir mentions the hadith. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned that تُحْشَرُونَ حُفَاتًا عُرَاتًا مُشَاتًا غُرَلًا, that on Judgment Day you will be resurrected. حُفَات means barefoot, عُرَات means completely nude, مُشَاتًا means you'll be walking in that condition, غُرَلًا means uncircumcised. And Sayyida Aisha asked Prophet ﷺ, O Messenger of Allah, we will be naked in front of each other. Won't we be looking at each other's nudeness? Yani her modesty, she couldn't imagine to be in that condition. And Prophet ﷺ said, quoted this verse, لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِيهِ. Everybody's concerns are enough to make him not look at anything. أو قال ما أشغله عن النظر. He said everybody will have things to busy him that he will not even see who's next to him. Not even look. تحشرون حفاة عراة غرلا صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ends this surah with two groups of people and their condition. He says, وجوه يومئذ مسفرة ضاحكة مستبشرة. On that day, you will find faces that are shining, smiling and happy and hopeful, rejoicing. ضاحكة مستبشرة. And on the opposite end, وجوه يومئذ عليها غبرة. And faces will have dust on it. ترهقها قترة. And will be blackened, will be dark. أولئك هم الكفرة الفجرة. These are the unbelieving, rebellious evildoers. And this is how the surah ends. So it ends with hope for the believers. وجوه يومئذ مسفرة. And the condition they will be in. And with the conditions of the unbelievers. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد حتى يرضى سيدنا محمد. And we go to Surah At-Takwir. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذا الشمس كورت وإذا السماء انفطرت. So Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم explained to us what this surah is about. صلى الله عليه وسلم had said عن سيدنا ابن عمر that Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من سره أن ينظر إلى يوم القيامة كأنه رأي عين فليقرأ إذا الشمس كورت وإذا السماء انفطرت وإذا السماء انشقت. So Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, if a person wants to see the conditions, what will happen on Judgment Day, the big signs of Judgment Day, he must read three surahs, which we will inshallah go over in this tafsir. إذا الشمس كورت, Surah التكوير. إذا الشمس انفطرت, Surah الانفطار. وإذا الشمس انشقت, وإذا السماء, إذا السماء انفطرت, سورة الانفطار. وإذا السماء انشقت, سورة الانشقاق. These three surahs give us the imagery and the description of the end times, Judgment Day, when the big signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala happen. So in this surah, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, إذا الشمس كورت. So in the tafsir, كورت means when it is darkened, when it is blackened, when it is folded, the sun. When the sun's light is no more. And hadith Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم that the sun and the moon will be rolled up, يعني will be يكوران, الشمس والقمر يكوران يوم القيامة, will be folded on Judgment Day. وإذا النجوم انكدرت. And when the stars are dispersed, scattered. When the stars have fallen and become scattered. عن سيدنا أنس رضي الله عنه that أبي بن كعب that he said six signs will take place before the day of judgment. The people will be in their marketplaces when the sun, when the sun's light will go away. And when they are at that, in that situation, the star will fall and be scattered. When they are in that situation, the mountain will fall down upon the face of the earth. And the earth will shake, will quake, and there will be a state of confusion. And the jinn will flee in fright out of fear to humans, and the humans will flee to the jinn. And the domestic beasts, birds, and wild animals will be in panic and mixed together. And they will surge together as a wave of chaos. So this is عن سيدنا أبي بن كعب. And this surah is describing this condition. وإذا الكواكب انتثرت أو وإذا النجوم انكدرت when the stars are scattered وإذا الوحوش حشرت and when the beasts are mixed together وإذا العشار عطلت and when the pregnant she camels are neglected, no one looks at them, yani, from the difficult condition. So this verse talks about the Ishar were the most precious for the Arabs in the desert. The most precious type of camel is the female camel, Ishar, that this camel, during its pregnancy in the 10th month, it's called, they call them Ishar, because Ashra means 10. In the 10th month, it requires so much attention from its owners. And because it's precious, they would have somebody looking after it all the time. So here the Quran is saying, even yani if Judgment Day has risen at that time, even nobody would look at these she-camels who are pregnant. No one pay attention. As precious as they are, in the difficulty of the situation, no one will pay attention to them. وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ سُجِّرَتْ And when the oceans, when the seas become flaming fire, سُجِّرَتْ وَإِذَا الْجِبَالُ سُيِّرَتْ Mountains will shatter, the earth will quake, the sun will be blackened, the stars will fall and scatter, and the beasts will be running in panic in waves. And the oceans will be pools of fire. Sujirat will be fire. And it is mentioned here that Ibn Jarir recorded from Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib that Sayyidina Ali karramallahu wajhahu said to a Jewish man, where is hell? And the man said the sea. And Sayyidina Ali said, I think he is truthful. As Allah says, وَالْبَحْرُ الْمَسْجُورِ And the kindled, the lit, the burning ocean. And he says, وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ سُجِّرَتْ And the seas that are blazing fire. وَإِذَا النُّفُوسُ زُوِّجَتْ And when the souls are joined with their pairs, when the pairs are joined, when souls are joined with their mates, Meaning every type of soul will be gathered with its peer or mate. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he says, أُحْشُرُ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا وَأَزْوَاجَهُمْ is resurrect, gather those who are oppressors with their mates. وَإِذَا النُّفُوسُ زُوِّجَتْ With their mates, not their wives, with their mates, means their companions who were paired with them. Because everyone has a qareen, has a devil as a qareen. So that Ibn Abi Hatim recorded from Abu Nu'man Bashir that the Messenger of Allah says, وَإِذَا النُّفُوسُ زُوِّجَتْ يعني, the meaning is when you are gathered again with your devil, if you are an oppressor, Allah will put you together. وَإِذَا الْمَوْؤُودَةُ سُئِلَتْ بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ. In Mawuda is the little female infant back in before Islam in the desert. They didn't like to have females as children, so they will bury their infants. I don't know, it's called what is it called today, infanticide or something like that. They will bury them alive to get rid of them if they had a female child. So Allah, the Holy Quran is saying, وَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ وَإِذَا الْمَوْؤُودَةُ سُئِلَتْ. And when that little child who was wronged and buried will be questioned, بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ, what was it is mistake? What, for what reason was that baby murdered? It will ask, it will be asked. Allah will bring that baby and ask that baby, what did you do wrong to deserve to be buried by your parents? And this brings to mind what is happening now today in this world. How many 15,000 children now in Gaza have been murdered? Babies, infants, toddlers, won't Allah ask these children, what did you do wrong? Why did you deserve these bombs to fall on your heads? These people who are blinded by their greed for dunya, these children will be witness. These children will have rights. These children can take them to task. Say, I want my right from these, but what did I do? I didn't do anything, my Lord. I was an innocent child and I was murdered. Allahumma afina. وَإِذَا الْمَوْؤُودَةُ سُئِلَتْ بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ. What did it commit? What kind of crime? It's called infanticide, I think. And it is still practiced in some places in the world, but now the innocent children are suffering all over the world because of the lack of morality, because of the lack of faith, because of the lack of belief in Judgment Day. Why people commit these atrocities? They don't believe that they will be account for their deeds. That's why they can do these things. But they will. And as Allah subhanahu, as we explained now, they will find themselves on Judgment Day and they will be horrified and terrified because they're about to be taken for accounting. And this happened, you know, some of the companions of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had committed this crime. It was something peer. The tribal pressure sometimes, when a person has too many daughters, sometimes they did that. So one of the companions of Prophet asked him, that it was Qais bin Asim radiallahu anh, came to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and asked him that I did bury my some daughters of mine alive. And the Messenger, Prophet ﷺ, said, free a slave for each one you buried. And he said, I don't have slaves, but I have camels. Then he said, then slaughter a camel for each one and distribute yani for the poor. وَإِذَا الصُّحُفُ نُشِرَتْ. And when people's books are published yani, and delivered, check now that we have Amazon delivering books everywhere, your book will be delivered on Judgment Day. وَإِذَا الصُّحُفُ نُشِرَتْ. Every person will be given his book, his scroll, his paper with his deeds in it. Sayyidina Qatada said, O son of Adam, your book will be written and then it will be rolled up and then it will be distributed to you on the day of judgment. So let each man look at what he himself dictated to be written. So look now, حاسبوا أنفسكم قبل أن تحاسبوا. Take yourself to account, accounting before you are taken to account. We are asking Allah, Ya Rabbi, we are weak ones. Sayyidina Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha wa ardaha to ask Allah for no accounting, because man nuqisha al-hisab udhiba, ya Aisha. He said, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you are called to be to accounting, if you are audited, that means you're in trouble. We're asking, Ya Rabbi, we are asking not to be taken, not to be audited, to be forgiven, inshallah. وَإِذَا السَّمَاءُ كُشِطَتْ. When the skies we see above us are stripped off. وَإِذَا الْجَحِيمُ سُعِيرَتْ. And when you have a fireplace and you add more wood to make it more hot, this is the same. وَإِذَا الْجَحِيمُ سُعِيرَتْ. When the hells are made even hotter and hotter. وَإِذَا الْجَنَّةُ أُزْلِفَتْ. And when heaven is brought near for its coming inhabitants. Al-Dhahaq Abu Malik Qatada al-Arabi all said this means that it will be brought near for its inhabitants. At that time, عَلِمَتْ نَفْسٌ مَا أَحْضَرَتْ. Everyone will know at that time what they have brought forth, what their deeds are. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma aafina, Allahumma thabbitna ala al-haq, اللهم تجاوز عن سيئاتنا يا رب. Inshallah we'll continue tomorrow with the tafsir. ومن الله التوفيق بحرمة الفاتحة. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد. بسم الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. جزاكم الله خيرا for watching. بارك الله.